Around 98 million years ago, in what is now Patagonia, there lived a large, terrifying predator. Giganotosaurus was one of the largest carnivorous theropods to ever walk the Earth, and has become an iconic dinosaur since its discovery. While it's not quite as popular as Tyrannosaurus rex, this animal has recently become more famous thanks to its role as the primary antagonist of Jurassic World Dominion. And while Jurassic World finally brought Giganotosaurus into the limelight, what was shown in the movies is far from what the animal was like in reality. So in this video, we will be taking a look at what Giganotosaurus was actually like and compare it to the Jurassic World's rendition. We will start by taking a look at what we know about Giganotosaurus according to science, and then we'll take a look at the Jurassic World Giganotosaurus to see how scientifically accurate it is. Enjoy! The holotype specimen of Giganotosaurus was first discovered in 1993. These fossils came from the Candeleros formation of Patagonia, and the skeleton was almost 70% complete. In 1995, the animal was named Giganotosaurus carolinii. The genus name, meaning giant southern lizard, and the species name was given to honor the discoverer, Ruben D. Carolini. Giganotosaurus is part of the Carcharodontosauridae family of theropod dinosaurs and is one of the largest members of the family. The name Carcharodontosauridae means shark-tooth lizards and was named after the first species added to the family, Carcharodontosaurus. Carcharodontosaurus were the largest predators of the early and middle Cretaceous and spanned all across the globe. The first Carcharodontosaurs emerged during the late Jurassic with species like Lucovenator. Over time, these animals continued to diversify and become both specialized and bizarre predators. Some evolved crazy features like Concavenator's signature hump, while others went towards gigantism. Towards the end of their evolution, Carcharodontosaurs began to grow larger and larger in size, leading to the giants like Giganotosaurus. Giganotosaurus could reach lengths of 13 meters long or almost 43 feet, and weighed a whopping 8.3 metric tons, or almost 18,300 pounds. In comparison, Sue the T-Rex weighed a staggering 9.7 metric tons, or 21,384 pounds. So Giganotosaurus may not have been bigger than a T-Rex, as we're so often led to believe, but hey, at least it was longer than a T-Rex. One thing that the T-Rex and Giganotosaurus shared in common, aside from being large, meat-eating theropods, was that they were both warm-blooded animals. In 1999, the paleontologist Reese E. Barrick and the geologist William J. Showers found that the bones of Giganotosaurus and Tyrannosaurus rex had similar oxygen isotope patterns, with similar heat distribution in the body. These thermoregulatory patterns indicate that these dinosaurs had a metabolism that was somewhere between that of a mammal's and a reptile's, and were therefore warm-blooded. The metabolism of an 8-ton Giganotosaurus would have been similar to that of a 1-ton mammalian carnivore, indicating that these animals would have grown rapidly. This would have also meant that these animals would need to eat an average of 30 kilograms of meat per day. While speed estimates vary, research done in 2016 by Asier Laramendi suggests that Giganotosaurus could reach speeds of up to 30 kilometers per hour. They may have used their speed to ambush their prey, or even target slower moving animals for a higher chance of success. Fossils of the closely related Mapusaurus were discovered in a bone bed consisting of 8 individuals at different growth stages. The different size ranges of animals present suggest that Mapusaurus adults were tolerant of smaller individuals, and weren't actively trying to eat or kill them. This led scientists to believe that these animals were part of a group and they died together due to a catastrophic event. Hunting in groups may have been advantageous when taking on large sauropods. Group hunting may have also increased their chances of success. Modern-day Harris hawks, a type of avian dinosaur, will hunt in cooperative groups of up to 2 to 6 individuals. These groups tend to be more successful than lone hawks, with a 10% increase in success per extra individual. However, it's still not 100% certain if Mapusaurus or Giganotosaurus were truly group hunters, or lived in a family unit. While the answer remains unclear, more discoveries will help scientists better determine the full picture. Despite being a massive predator, Giganotosaurus did not have a strong bite. A 2005 study done by Dr. Francois Therrien and colleagues showed that the bite force of a T-Rex was 3 to 5 times greater than that of a Giganotosaurus. In fact, Giganotosaurus and the related Acrocanthosaurus had relatively weak bite forces. Instead, their jaws were more adapted to slicing bites. This is further supported by the shape of their teeth. Giganotosaurus had flat, serrated blade-like teeth, similar to those seen in other Carcharodontosaurs. These teeth were perfect for slicing through the flesh of dinosaurs. The authors also suggest that Giganotosaurus was a generalized predator, and fed on a wide variety of prey. They most likely targeted prey smaller than themselves, such as juvenile sauropods. They may have also just bitten chunks off of larger sauropods, similar to what modern-day orcas do to baleen whales. Furthermore, the absolute Chad chin of a Giganotosaurus may have actually been an adaptation for resisting tensile stress when the bite was delivered with the front of the jaws against the prey. Who knew that such a cool feature was there for more than just looks? Giganotosaurus lived in the Candeleros formation approximately 99.6 to 97 million years ago. The environment at the time was mostly semi-arid, with some rivers and streams. Giganotosaurus shared this landscape with the Titanosaur Andosaurus and the Rebbachisaurid Limaiosaurus. These sauropods may have been primary prey items for Giganotosaurus. Being the largest carnivore in the region, an adult Giganotosaurus would have been the apex predator and would have little to fear. However, there was another large predator in the region, an abelisaurid Ecrixonatosaurus. Ecrixonatosaurus is one of the largest abelisaurids to ever exist, and it's still unclear if these animals were in direct competition with Giganotosaurus. Maybe they often clashed, or they avoided each other by fulfilling different ecological niches. If a fight were to ensue between the two animals, Giganotosaurus would most likely win by using its larger size to intimidate and scare off opponents. Giganotosaurus was truly an awesome and awe-inspiring animal and would have reigned supreme until its extinction around 97 million years ago. So now that we've gone over what Giganotosaurus was really like as an animal, let's compare it to the Jurassic World version. For starters, we're gonna look at the head anatomy. The first inaccuracy here is that the Jurassic World Giganotosaurus lacks the absolute Chad chin of the real animal. Instead of giving the animal the more scientifically accurate absolute Chad chin, the Jurassic World Giganotosaurus was given a softer, weak sauce chin instead. Tragic. Moving on, the shape of the teeth are incorrect and are much thicker than the actual animal's teeth. Furthermore, their uneven and jagged arrangement isn't the most realistic and was done to give the Giganotosaurus a more gnarly appearance. In reality, the teeth would have been in a more organized row to help better assist with slicing bites. The skull shape of the Dominion Giganotosaurus seems to be based on older reconstructions of the animal, with a more slender and elongated appearance. The more up-to-date and modern-day reconstructions of Giganotosaurus show a much more stout and compact skull. Another notable feature of the Jurassic World Dominion Giganotosaurus skull is its sharp, blade-like crest. While there isn't direct fossil evidence for such a feature, it's not entirely out of the realm of possibility. In fact, the brow of Giganotosaurus is extensively long, with a knobby, rugose texture alongside the skull. In life, this could have supported a keratin structure of some sorts, so a keratin crest of some form could have been present. Now let's move on to the body. One of the most notable attributes of the Jurassic World's designs are the large spikes and osteoderms running along the neck and back of the animal. Osteoderms are bones embedded within the skin and are seen on modern-day crocodilians. However, Giganotosaurus and other Carcharodontosaurs didn't have such integument. The Dominion Giganotosaurus also has a protruding hump on its back, which is further accentuated by the spikes and osteoderms. Now, one thing that the Jurassic World Dominion design actually did get right was the position of the arms and wrists of the animal. Up until now, all of the Jurassic World theropods had pronated wrists, meaning that their palms faced downwards. In reality, theropod wrists pointed towards each other, similar to modern-day birds. The Jurassic World Giganotosaurus actually has this correct wrist placement. The only major difference is that the arms of the real Giganotosaurus would have been slightly smaller. And finally, the last inaccuracy worth mentioning is the time period. The Jurassic World Dominion prologue is set during the end of the Cretaceous period at 65 million years ago. However, we now know that the Cretaceous period actually ended 66 million years ago. And of course, Giganotosaurus shouldn't be here since it died out 97 million years ago. The only reason it was featured here was so that it could have a face-off with a T-Rex. One of the main reasons why Jurassic World dinosaurs typically get a pass for being so inaccurate is because they are genetically engineered with modern-day animal DNA added in to fill in the gaps. However, the Giganotosaurus featured in the Cretaceous prologue looks the exact same as the modern-day clone, so that excuse doesn't really apply here. It would have been nice if the prologue Giganotosaurus was actually anatomically accurate and up-to-date, because if anything, that would better reinforce the idea that the dinosaurs in Jurassic World that are shown in the modern day are not meant to be identical to their extinct counterparts. But if that was the case, I wouldn't have made this video. Before I conclude this video, it's important to mention that nothing stated here is to necessarily discredit or disprove of the Jurassic World design. Rather, the entire purpose of this video was to better illustrate the differences between the fantasy of Jurassic World and the reality of the fossil record. The scientific accuracy of Jurassic World dinosaurs will always be a contentious subject, since it never seems entirely fair comparing movie monsters to the real extinct animals. However, these films have a tremendous impact on the public's perception of dinosaurs and do an excellent job invigorating public interest. The goal of these videos is to use that interest to create a more healthy and fun approach to science communication. Through my artwork and animation, I hope to make learning about the movies and the real science fun and enjoyable for everyone. And while I crack jokes here and there, I promise it is not out of bad faith. After all of us love dinosaurs and enjoy these Jurassic movies. Any dialogue about dinosaurs is good, so might as well have fun with it. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel and sharing this video with others who might enjoy it as well. Be sure to follow Nature's Compendium on social media to stay up to date on all the latest projects. If you would like to help support the channel in making more animated science content about dinosaurs and other extinct animals, you can do so by pledging to our Patreon page. Here, you can expect to get access to behind-the-scenes content, as well as exclusive rewards like this Patreon-only woolly mammoth mug, or this Giganotosaurus poster. As always, thank you for watching.